Hey there guys, happy new year and welcome back to CubeBrick. New year means new mocks, so today we're starting a brand new castle building series here on this channel, and as usual, it's gonna be a really fun one. So as it normally is with starting a brand new series, today I'm going to show you the basic concept of what I'm planning, talk about the story a little bit, briefly go through the minifigure selection I've selected for this mock, and of course, I'm going to show you what I've already started building. So let's not waste any more time and let's get started right now. I've been thinking a lot about what I should build next after disassembling all of my mocks I had laying around after last year, and as you might know, to get some help in deciding, I've created a poll on my community tab on what team should I go with. And you guys have of course selected the castle team. Luckily, I had an idea growing in my head for some time now, and I guess it's time to make it real. Even though I made a part of a medieval village in front of Edge of Bricks Castle, I wanted to make some kind of a castle myself. But the more I thought about it, I came to realize that I'm not yet ready for a full-sized castle build, both mentally as well as part-wise, so we're going to build something not quite there yet, but still it should be impressive enough to get both me and all of you excited. So what are we building this time is a Black Falcon Fortress, or a fortified outpost if you will, built on a rocky island with some strong fortifications and a big tower above all, hence the name Falcon's Nest. So let's start with the minifigure selection, which are of course the Black Falcons. I won't get into too much details of making the army because you've already seen a fair share of those in my last building series, but I guess we can briefly check out our heroes that will be stuck with us for the next couple of episodes. So of course we have our higher ranking officers that will be in charge of the troops inside of the stronghold that you should know well from my previous builds. Next we have our regular troops manning the fortress, like a squad of pikemen, a couple of axemen, heavy infantry with swords and shields, and to defend the walls, a couple of archers and crossbowmen. And maybe some civilian looking workers helping around the fortress dressed in the Bard outfit from the 22nd minifigure series. I will probably add some more troops since I have a couple of torsos and legs still laying around. I just need to order some accessories for them. But to tell the truth, things are not the most exciting part of the build, so enough of that. And let's talk about the actual fortress I'll be making. I was digging around for some kind of an inspiration on Pinterest and I came across this awesome tabletop build for a fortress by Mark Kiefer, and I immediately knew that this is what I had growing in my head. Of course, I don't want to make an exact copy of this build, but rather use it as sort of a source material because I have a lot of different ideas for it, which I will talk about in just a moment. First, we need to establish the size and the structure of what the stronghold will look like. So I wanted something of a maximum size of 50 by 50 studs, so I've started with making the freeform base. This is actually the third attempt of making the base for the build, but finally it's the type of structure I'm aiming at. Like I said, I wanted something on a rocky island, but to add a little twist, I decided to make the rock not only sticking out of the water, but also show what is actually under the surface. Let's just call it a freeform on steroids. So these dark grey slopes indicate what part of an island will be under the water, which should add some nice vibes to the build. Above the water level we will have also a part of the rockwork, which will be mostly made in light grey, and then the rocks will gradually transform into a stone wall surrounding the fortress. The shape should be something similar to the mentioned tabletop, so to make my life a bit harder, I will make a part of a rockwork at an angle, and from here we will have the fortified walls finished up with some nice battlements. The entry gate will be my own take on the fortress, and it will be made here on the side, with I think a part of a bridge leading to the inside of the structure cut somewhere in the middle. On the inside we shall of course have a courtyard filled with armed troops, And on the side we will have the tower overlooking the fortress with some wooden hoardings surrounding the top and a nice roof to finish it off. I'm not yet sure if that will be the only structure included here or will I build another smaller tower like the source material, but I guess it will depend on the space I will have available here since the whole mock will not be too big and I will have to fit all of the buildings on about 32 by 32 base. Okay, so now that we have the basic draft of what I'm planning, it's time to see what I actually was able to build already. And while it may not seem like a lot, I managed to make a fair share of the rockwork already before I ran out of dark gray slopes I had. To be honest, I thought that I had a lot of these slopes, but it turned out I wasn't even able to make a half of the rockwork, so of course I had to make some bricklinks orders already. But what I did is looking great in my opinion. The rockwork may not be too advanced in terms of techniques being used, but I myself really like this type of structures and I think it should look even better when finished all around the base. To indicate that this part is underwater, I've outlined the water level using some translucent plates and tiles, and of course added some seaweed sticking out of the rocks with even a couple of fishes swimming around. I'm not quite sure yet if the rockwork will be surrounding the whole mock from all sides or just three of them, with the fourth one being a flat cut surface with some kind of a cave inside, maybe with some dungeons underneath the fortress, but I guess that will get clearer as I continue to build. But what is certain is that the next step will be making this angled part of the rockwork below the future tower, which will definitely be a tricky part, but I have a basic idea of how I want to make it, so it's just a matter of transferring what I have in my head to the actual build. And as you might have noticed, I've also made the inside skeleton of the island with Duplo bricks. It's becoming more of a standard in my tall builds to be using those, because it's such a brick saver and in the same time it's a very solid structure to build on. Of course, I left some space between the slopes and the skeletons to have some flexibility while building, because in this stage it's all due to change. But for now, you get the picture, right? And if you do, please let me know in the comment section how do you like what I started here, because that is actually all of the work I have done for this episode. As always, I am open to all your suggestions regarding this build and some ideas you might have to make my mock even better. But for now, I think we can wrap this up. So leave a like if you enjoyed what you just saw, subscribe to my channel to make sure you won't miss the next episode as well as many other cool stuff I am planning for this year, and as usual, make sure to keep it brickin'.